Hey folks, today we're going to take a look at the Breg T-scope. We use it a lot of times after knee surgeries to help restrict range of motion and also remind folks not to go wild after their surgery. However, we also use it sometimes in the acute setting in order to help some injuries restrict the range of motion. Before we start showing you how to put it on, I'm going to show you the different components of it. All right. First of all, which way is up? Three different ways you can look at it. One, the square pad will always be on the bottom or facing the toes. Two, this red tab will be closer to the head than the toes. Or three, if you like your alphabet, D's and B's are good. Nines and P's are bad, all right? Then, once you've got the orientation figured out, you need to decide how long does it need to be. We aim for middle of the thigh to just above the ankle. And the way that can be achieved is by telescoping the edge of the brace, and you can see there are markers to help keep it consistent. They may be different from the top and lower portions, but make sure that on each side, it's at the same point. Next, the brace, as you can see, is very rigid right now, and that's because of the lock button. If you push it up, you'll be able to move the brace. Push it down and it'll lock back in position. As far as how much the brace can move is dependent upon these gray tabs. If you need to change it, you can pull it up and adjust to wherever is necessary. Your provider will likely tell you where this should be set for the moment. However, note, the white is for extension or straightening of the knee, and the black or the flexion is for the bending of the knee, all right? When you're tightening the brace, you have a couple of different points to do so. One is this friction clip, and this helps you take slack out of the brace or to loosen it up if it gets too tight. Second, you clip the brace in and you pull the slack out of the front. Now, let's take a look at how to put it on. We've got Dr. Pendleton, one of our sports medicine surgeons, to serve as an example. Hey, Dr. Pendleton. Thank you very much. Note that first thing, we make sure mid-thigh to just above the ankles. These circular pads should be right at the point of the knee where the knee joint bends. So I'm gonna adjust it just about an inch or so, thank you. Now, I think it's easier to put the brace on when it's locked straight at 0 degrees, but depending upon your range of motion, that might not be possible. First, what I will do is I will connect this clip for the strap just above the knee. And you can see when I did that, it kept the pads away from the sides and started angling them forward. That's something we want to adjust. And you can do so by loosening the slack. You want the pads to be directly in contact with the side of the leg. Once you've done that, undo this friction clip and pull the slack from behind the leg. Reapply it to tighten it up. Then you can readjust this strap, and it has a Velcro tab which will adhere to the cloth of the brace. Now you can see the pads are flush against the sides of Dr. Pendleton's knee. We unlock the brace and we see that it moves right where his knee bends as well. Now, once I've done that strap to anchor, I will go below the knee and I will take the slack out, followed by the very top strap, and lastly, the very bottom strap. I think this is the easiest way to maintain the proper position at the knee, and that's what's very important here. Once you've got that situated, you'll take the remaining clips in that same order. You clip it to the other side, pull the slack out of the front, and attach towards the back of the brace. Note that sometimes when you have the strap and you pull it tight, you'll go to attach it and you realize it doesn't attach to fabric and instead attaches to plastic. In that situation, take this tab off. You can either fold it or you can also cut it. Reattach the Velcro tab and now you can attach the brace appropriately. Sometimes the brace can be too tight or too loose. As your swelling increases in the first couple of days after surgery, you may have to undo the clip and the Velcro tab and give yourself a little slack by undoing that strap and repeating the steps that we discussed earlier. All right. As your swelling goes down after surgery, follow these instructions, but you'll likely be tightening the brace because the swelling has gone down and the muscles oftentimes atrophy or get a little bit smaller and weaker. Lastly, it's important to note that once you've done this setup, you're ready to go. The surgeon or healthcare provider will help tell you how much the knee can bend and straighten, and then the removal and reapplication of the brace is simple. All you have to do then is undo your clips. I hope this makes what can sometimes be a daunting task a little bit easier. Thanks.